Welcome back to the channel. Today we will discuss about Lost Ark, one of the most hyped MMORPG in recent years, one that in our imagination will become the next main game that we will be playing for months to come and forget we have to eat, sleep and even go to the bathroom, so stick until the end to find out. With nothing to say anymore, let's start with the character creation.
Here we can first see the classes. We have martial artist and gunner, both of them having their male and female variants. Then we have warrior, assassin and mage, and they are gender locked for now. The game has many more classes and more will be available, but these are the ones that we can play right now at launch. Most of the classes have some subclasses that you can pick. For my warrior, I had berserker, a big sword guy that slashes through everything, a paladin, that is a support class in essence, and then we have the gunlancer, a tanky guy with a tower shield and a combination of a gun and lance for a weapon. That is a very unique item and a really cool one that you don't really see that often. On this screen, you can also see that each class has a really cool animation when you select them. These are really eye-catching and well made. All of them feel really unique and you will want to have some alternative characters. Okay, after I picked my gunlancer, the next step was his customization. You have some nice presets if you want a quick creation. Also, if you want a more in-depth one, you can change your hairstyles quite a bit and make a combination of colors in a two-tone like I did. You can change the shape of your chin, ears, cheeks and stuff like that. Maybe you don't have the complexity of Black Desert, but it is quite nice. So in conclusion, you have what to play here. Let's proceed to the next department and describe the gameplay mechanics, but before that, you can support me in the fight with the Algorithm Beast by dropping a like shield around the video. You can also become part of the legacy by subscribing to the channel. Well, the game starts with me choosing a path. It's cool that I can try the classes before choosing one. This feature should be present in all MMORPGs. Then, I am greeted with another cutscene and the game prologue begins. Although the game is isometric, you have some portions where you jump and climb. The game also has some quick time events where I can choose to save somebody or let him die. Unfortunately, that doesn't affect the story, but it's great to have them nonetheless. After I beat the spider boss and I see that I am a destiny child and the priest that was with me is in fact a demon in disguise, I finish the prologue and arrive in the starting area of the game. Just right after that, I decide that I will change the class because it feels a little too slow. So, after a long debate with myself between a paladin or a berserker, I went with the paladin, being still a shielding and supporting class. One thing that I noticed really early is that Lost Ark gives you a big inventory right from the start without any pressure on you to buy something from the cash shop in order to expand it. This is such a rare sight in today's MMORPG market. I don't know why developers still do not understand that the player community makes the game and will spend money into it if the game is worth it and are playing long enough to get attached on their character. If you ask from the beginning a lot of money from the player just for some basic things, of course your game will die. And even like this, there are a lot of whales. What is a whale, you ask? People that spend a lot of money into a game because they are used for them to be like that. They basically keep the game alive when the devs only want easy cash grab. Lost Ark gameplay feels really smooth and engaging. I can't wait to go and destroy some more trash mobs that explodes into tiny bits of flesh. And they do just that because you are a god amongst them, or at least a hero. Each skill you use has great effects and animations, and you will use them a lot because the game doesn't really focus too much on basic attacks. Also, you can customize your skills how you want to better suit your style. Every skill has 3 rounds of different effects you can apply for them, called tripods. You can either make them do more damage to trash mobs, to shield you, have a longer range, casting time, cooldown, have another element, have another attack or change the direction, and some of them even changes their animation completely. In this game, you will want to use more builds, depending on situation. Maybe you will do solo dungeons and you will want a lot of AoE clear, or maybe you will go for a raid and would be better to have more single target skills or some party buffing ones. Or maybe you will just play PvP and you want your own build. You have a lot of possibilities here, each class having 8 active skills and another one that is your identity, like berserker going mad, and having more crit chance and damage, also more attack speed and movement speed. Or like gunlancers, having an energy shield. Also, an awakening skill too, that has insane effects and you will have your jaw to the ground every time you will use it. You can customize even further with something called engraving. Those gives you some basic buffs that you can upgrade to, but not with skill points, but from reading books from normals to legendary rarity in order to max them out. For example, the Berserker class had something called Madness that permanently puts you into Berserker mode but also reduces the damage you take by 65%, so it's worth a trade. Other things that Lost Ark offers you is active items, like grenades from what I experienced, that you can throw and kill monsters. Those have different effects too, like freezing, holy and things like that. I can't describe them that much because I was always forgetting that I have those. What can I do? The game was that immersive. You also have potions that gives you shield or movement speed that I think are useful against bosses. In terms of dungeons, they are really what you would expect from that world. An instance where you go and expect a lot of traps, a lot of monsters and a big boss at the end. Lost Ark really offers this experience for us, the players. Also, you have activities like climbing, ziplining, jumping on cliffs and things like that. Although, you just have to press G on your keyboard and that puts you into animation, a new thing for MMORPGs of this type. One dungeon that I remember in particular was one where I fought Thanatos and at his final phase I had to redirect sunlight into him in order to destroy him permanently. Okay, so let's check the next department and talk about story and the questing system. The quest in this game has dialogue options and have a bit of voice acting at the beginning of the conversation to know a little what the quest is about, because nobody reads all the quests besides Asmongold. Lost Ark has your traditional fetch quest, but they are pretty chill, because you won't have to kill 50 monsters in order to complete one part of the quest, and in terms of gathering stuff, sometimes you will need maybe one thing to finish it. Side missions never felt a drag, and I was enjoying them a lot. Beside your traditional ones, you have a lot of different kind of quests, where you do activities like playing with kids, or talking to NPC by writing in the chat /talk, and the character will enter into an animation. You also have situations where you have to encourage NPC, make a sad face, or even dance. At higher levels, you will receive cooler quests, where you will transform into an occultist priest in order to infiltrate and disrupt a ritual. Another example was where I was playing as Airman, a priest NPC that is half demon. Here, I had to save some civilians. Then, I had to fight some bad knights in my demon form. Another great mission was when I raided a castle to help the new king regain his throne, or one, where we were raided by the demon army and I had to use the cannons to defend against them. Lost Ark has so many quests like that, accompanied by really great looking cutscenes and animations of what is happening. The game is so immersive and I was looking forward for the next main story quest and cutscene. Don't see this too often in MMORPGs. Okay, so let's talk about the story. From what I played, it is a little bit generic, but it is still great and has some plot twists. You have to find the Lost Arks in order to fight the demon army. From their perspective, the light exited chaos and disturbed the balance. You are a simple man that will become one of the chosen. I know that on endgame you will fight the demon commanders, but I don't know how the story will unfold after finding all the 7 arcs and what the expansions will bring to the table, but I assure you it will not disappoint because the devs are really invested into the game and listen to the community overall. So, expect great things. Let's see the atmosphere and the environment. Well, from the beginning, you can see that the game looks amazing. Great graphics, great cutscenes, great atmosphere and environment, and then, the impact of the skill is on another level, one that gives you addiction. You have a lot of different zones, and the overall world map is pretty big. You can explore it by boat after level 40, and you will discover other continents where you will have to do quests for completion of the raster character. That means, it is an overall level for all of your characters on the specific server, and it will give you passive bonuses like permanent increased stats. The immersion of the game is really what you would expect from an MMORPG. A lot of player hopping around and doing different tasks. The maps are full everywhere at any time. What is great is if multiple people attack a pack of monsters, all of you will get rewarded and will complete the mission. This encourages players to help each other and really creates a social aspect, something essential for this genre. Lost Ark really has a lot to offer from day one, and you have so many activities you can do. You can explore the world map, evolve your gathering skills, upgrade your stronghold, where you can craft endgame potions. You can also upgrade your ship and crew and do activities on the sea. Also, you have world bosses, endgame raids, and those are all amazing too. Abyssal and Chaos dungeon for farming, or if you want something more competitive, you can hop into PvP. It is skill based and doesn't care about gear or anything else. You'll create your build and then try to go up in rank, and it matters only how you play. The cash shop is also fair and the game is not pay to win. You can even change gold that you farm in this game for the shop's currency. So, the game can boost your character if you spend money, but you don't really have to because you can earn everything from just playing. Also, it will boost only your PvE experience, so it's your decision. Okay, so let's talk about the game pros and cons, but before you do that, drop a like shield around the video to protect us from the algorithm beast in case you haven't done it already. Also, if you want to check more first impression gameplay videos of all kinds of games, become part of the legacy by subscribing to the channel. This will also motivate me in doing more videos. If you think I skipped something or have another opinion, feel free to comment. And don't forget, I try games, so you don't have to waste your time. So, what I liked about Lost Ark is in essence, just everything. The game is, like I said before, what you would expect from an MMORPG. Every class feels unique and the gameplay is really impactful and has one of the flashiest skills ever. You will want to try every class and try different builds because you have plenty of options too. The story is pretty good, although clichéic, but it compensates with beautiful cutscenes and great mission design that will keep you hooked. The zones are amazing too and have again beautiful design and effects. For now, it has a huge player base, but I think in the future this will still be true because the game really has a lot to offer and feel really great when you play it. At endgame, you can do raids, dungeons, PvPs, social activities like fishing or gathering herbs, you can customize your stronghold, you can even sail and explore different islands where you will find rewards. The game has live quality features like fast traveling, gold that is shared on account, side activities that improves your stats on all your characters, and a lot of little details that I can't even remember, but makes the game a really fun experience and keeps you engaged. In terms of what I disliked, I don't really have any major issue with Lost Ark, maybe some minor things, but are easily overlooked. So, in conclusion, Lost Ark is one of the greatest MMORPGs you can find on the market right now, and is totally free. All the hype about the game was worth the waiting and it passes all criteria. You'll for sure forget to eat and go to the bathroom when you are in this game, just go download it right now, the game is so totally worth your time. Okay, so this will end the video, thank you guys for watching and supporting me. See you next time. May the gods of good raps be with you in your grindy days.